character of Antsy is my favorite character. He is just a fun, fun character. And his voice sort of came about very naturally. When I first had come up with the idea for the Schwa Was Here, it was really, this is one of those instances where the whole idea sort of came all together. I was speaking at a school, and a teacher had pointed out that when I was answering questions in the group, that there was one boy who was smack in the middle of my field of vision, whose hand was up, and I wasn't calling on him. And even when I looked at him, I didn't notice him there, just because of the way, you know, he was wearing a shirt that was the same color as the chair and a bunch of other things. And the idea came to me that I want to write a story about an unnoticeable kid. And we were in a school library, and he was sitting in front of the big dictionary, and I thought, well, this kid is kind of like a schwa, that unnoticeable sound in the English language. And that's where the idea came from. I remember knowing at that moment, this is going to be my next book. And then when the bell rang at the end of that period, I ran down and started writing. But basically became, the first couple of pages, the schwa was here, which never happens. You know, it never happens that just the voice just comes right away. But I sort of instinctively knew that it couldn't be told by the schwa. It had to be told by a kid who was a little bit of the opposite of that, who was kind of loud and obnoxious and sort of talked in run-on sentences. And really it was because of the stream of consciousness that I had when I was first starting to write it. And it, you know, that just became the character of Antsy. And he was just so much fun to write. You know, he was sort of an amalgam of kids that I knew growing up, because I grew up in Brooklyn, New York. This is really, the Schwa Was Here was the first story that took place in the Brooklyn that I remember growing up in. Even though it's a contemporary story, it's basically my childhood Brooklyn. And he was just such a fun character. He would come up with these sort of like questionable wisdom that he would have that was just a lot of fun. He would come up with these things. He didn't realize how wise he was about things. And he would come up with these things offhand, like, you know, life is like a bad haircut. And he has this whole thing about how life is like a bad haircut. And it kind of makes sense, but it's also funny. And so I never intended to write a sequel to the Schwa Was Here at all, because the schwa story is told. But then I realized I can write another story from Antsy's point of view, and it can be a completely different story. Just Antsy is the storyteller. And I got very excited about that idea. Antsy Does Time became the book that it became in sort of a little bit of a backwards way. The first book, the kid that the story was about, was the schwa. So I thought, well, what if I sort of go with that and use some sort of phonetic symbol? And I thought of the umlaut, you know, the two dots over the U. And so I thought, well, okay, there's a kid whose last name is umlaut. You know, he's Scandinavian. And then that made me think of Ingmar Bergman films and these you know, grandiose, depressing foreign films. And I thought, oh, this is a kid who is obsessed with death. And that sort of evolved into the story, and it sort of tied in with the fact that, you know, a student had asked me, before I was starting to write Antsy Does Time, a student had asked me, how come, you know, both Everlost and Unwinder are about death? And I thought, well, I've dealt with death in these different ways. What if Antsy is dealing with death? And that, I thought, was very exciting, because after writing Unwind, it was such a serious and heavy and disturbing book. I felt I sort of had to take everything and turn it on its ear. It says, okay, I'll write about death again, but I'm going to make it funny. And there was a challenge. How can I write a story about death and make it funny? And I just love the challenge of doing things like that. So that was the goal in writing Antsy.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.